Hi, this is part three of my stillbirth story, which is going to be about my uterine septum and my septum removal surgery. If you haven't watched parts one and two, I would definitely recommend that you watch those before, just to get an idea of how we got here and how we got this diagnosis. Here we go. So you would think that the story ends there, but unfortunately, the story does not. If you remember in the beginning of the story, when I was having my D&E and having my cervix dilated, they had some issues figuring out what was going on down there. Excuse me. Whether I had two cervixes, two uteruses, a uterus with a septum in it, all kinds of different things. I go to get referred to a reproductive endocrinologist who meets with me and gets me to get an MRI of my my uterus done. If you've ever had an MRI, I'm so sorry. I almost had a panic attack in there. You're in this tube. And I did not expect it to be so loud. I've had a CAT scan before when I was really young, and so that's kind of what I expected it to be, quick and fast, silent, no big deal. An MRI, oh my gosh. Luckily, I had basically like this much of my head out of the tube. I know people who get an MRI of their head have to be totally enclosed in this thing that's barely, you know, 6 inches in front of you, which is, I don't think that I'm a claustrophobic person, but it was so scary, and it's so loud. I had my arms up here, and I had my ears plugged, and it was so loud, I was freaking out. It sucks. I'm definitely gonna try to never get one of those again in my life, because it really, really sucked. So I had one of those done. I had many, many ultrasounds done and try to figure out what is actually going on in there. And finally find out that I do not have two cervixes, but I do have a uterus that has a septum going all the way down. So for a little anatomy lesson, I have a little easel for you. Here's our anatomy lesson of the day. A uterus is normally just a circle, right? Normal, ordinary uterus. And it goes down into a cervix that then opens up to vagina, blah, 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 blah. My uterus looks like this. All of this is extra tissue, which goes all the way down to the cervix, meaning that it only just looked like I had two cervixes when I really had one, which was separated all the way down by this very, very large septum. Weird. I know, I'd never heard of it before this happened to me. I felt like a complete freak of nature, like I had two noses or something. It's actually not super uncommon, like people definitely have it. So the whole thought of it really, you know, freaked me out. I was like, why does this happen to me? Like, I just went through the worst thing in the entire world, and now I have something that's really wrong with my reproductive system. Like, just give me a freaking break. Sorry, I was about to say a very bad word there. Just give me a break, world. Like, just one, just a break would be awesome. So we kind of discuss the pros and cons of having the surgery. Obviously, with any surgery, there's gonna be risks and stuff like that involved with it. My main concern was, were the risks outweighing the benefits of having the surgery. Apparently the surgery is pretty quick. All that tissue in the middle doesn't have a blood supply or anything, so you basically just like shave that whole thing down. So finally decide to get the surgery done. It's for the best. They highly, highly recommended it, especially because we've already had a loss. They didn't want to, obviously the loss didn't have anything to do with the septum, but they didn't want to have something that could possibly trigger a loss or some kind of something going wrong in the future, especially when we've already gone through it once before, so that we can have the best outcome of pregnancy next time. So I had the surgery in April of this year. I was really, really scared. I've never had like an invasive surgery before. I've gone under general anesthesia a couple of times before. So that part of it never really freaked me out, but just the fact that I was having some kind of a surgery was really, really scary for me. I was scared that something was going to happen and I was not going to be able to have kids. Something was going to go wrong and I wasn't ever going to be able to conceive again. All kinds of things were running through my head. So I was warned that it might take two different surgeries to get the entire septum taken out. It was apparently hard to tell unless you're actually like up in there how long it would take. They're expecting the surgery to take about 2 hours, possibly a second surgery. So the surgery ended up taking, I believe, about 4.5 hours, which is a lot longer than they expected, but they were able to get the entire thing out. So I wake up from surgery, I ask, you know, how did it go? And they said it went perfectly. They were able to get the whole thing out. They're hoping that they're not going to have a second surgery, which for me, that was the first good news I had had in almost an entire year. So I had a little tiny balloon, they call it, put inside of my uterus that I feel like it's pretty typical for them to leave something in there just so that it is kind of the uterus. Well, I mean, it's tiny. It's like, you know, that small. The uterus is actually, they have this thing in there. It's filled with saline, I believe, and you know, it's about that big. It's tiny. You can't feel it. 2 weeks later, I went in for my post-op appointment and to get that little thingy out. They basically told me to. I was kind of concerned that it was really gonna suck to get that thing out. But they basically just they empty the thing out so that it's not filled with that liquid anymore, and then they just asked me to cough. And they were like, 1, 2, 3, cough. And I did 1, 2, 3, cough. And that's when they took it out at the same time. And I didn't even feel anything. So that's good. So if there's anyone that's having that surgery, that part is like not a big deal at all. It's totally fine. So then about, I want to say 1 month later, they wanted to do a saline ultrasound, which is where they put a catheter into your cervix and fill your uterus with saline and then do an ultrasound on top of that. And yeah, it sucks. Straight up. It's kind of painful, but you know, it only lasts like a minute or two. Actually, I think the only painful part was getting the catheter in there. Yeah. Lots of things have been in there that I would never want to happen again. Yeah, put the catheter in there, fill it up with saline, do the ultrasound, and they just wanted to see how much the septum is still there, if they needed to have another surgery. And we find out that I do not have to have another surgery. They got the whole thing out. They got everything out that they wanted to. Awesome news. I didn't want to have to go through all that again. I was so impatient to, try to have a baby right away. We had been waiting for long enough. At this point, it was a year since we conceived Aria. So I was just ready to have a baby right away. Unfortunately, you can't do that right away. You have to wait 3 cycles. So we had to wait 4 cycles to try to have a baby again. Kind of cheated and started at 3 cycles, but nothing happened in that first time. So it didn't really make a difference, I guess. We got pregnant within 3 months, which is amazing. They said that sometimes people who have a septum can have a hard time getting pregnant to begin with. That didn't seem to be the case with me, because with Aria, we also got pregnant in exactly 3 months. So, I don't know. It seems pretty average to get pregnant in 3 months. So, yeah, that is my uterine septum / uterine septum story / stillbirth story. It's definitely a long one. And yeah, hopefully this, I don't know, hopefully this helps someone, or I don't know. It's not really a super entertaining story, but it's my story. And this has been my life for about a year and a half, about 1 year and 7 months. Yeah. I don't really know how to end this video, but thank you for watching. Yeah, this one's for you, Aria. I love you.